Hello, I'm Will Goodhart. I'm the Chief Executive at CFA UK, and I'm also a board member at the Impact Investing Institute.
Nathalie Dogniez, I'm a partner at PwC. I lead the EMEA ESG team. So, how did you find this panel this afternoon?
I thought it was a great discussion. It's obviously a critically important issue. We were teed up for it very well by Martin, who talked about the development of ESG and really moving into sustainability. I thought we had a very useful and interesting discussion around diversity and some of the practical aspects of diversity, as well as the influence that diversity can have on investment returns. And I was actually quite impressed with the level of knowledge that there obviously already was in the audience, though I think we also managed to give them something useful to take home with them from the Congress. How did you feel it went?
Well, I feel it went well, and as you said, I was quite surprised when we asked the audience to make some projection about, you know, ESG product in 10 years' time, that everybody seems now convinced that, you know, it will become like the norm to integrate ESG in one way or another in the products. Now, I had the feeling also that, you know, the public was not necessarily aware of the magnitude and the timing of the upcoming changes introduced by the Sustainable Finance Action Plan.
Yes, I think that's right. I think under the awareness of the full details of that plan and the role that the taxonomy is going to play in the investing universe, I think clearly many people are still sort of getting to grips with that. And I think we saw that in some of the data around when is this going to be introduced, how much of an impact do you think it's going to have. But again, I didn't feel as though we were preaching to the fully converted, but there was a lot of sympathy in the room for ESG and sustainability more broadly.
I would say more than, you know, sympathy. Nowadays, I think the shift that I've seen over the last 2 years is that now people believed in it. Well, at least they believe when they see the inflows and the, yes, investors' demand. And the upcoming regulation will accelerate that flow, with investors being asked systematically what are their ESG preference. It's likely to unlock the investor demand to even a broader scale.
I think that's right. I think there is still, though, some work to be done, clearly in terms of new standards around greenwashing and making sure that people really understand the sustainable investment product that they're buying, and whether it is deep green or light green, or actually really not very green at all, but just taking into consideration ESG factors with respect to future investment risk. But my sense again is that there are many people who are helping to push us towards that standardization. And we have, although we have too many standards at the moment, we're in flight in terms of bringing those standards together and having them coalesce into a smaller set of reporting and disclosure standards that I think will be genuinely helpful in the future.
I totally agree with you, and this is why I'm a supporter of this disclosure regulation, which is really driving you not to regulate, not telling you what is ESG and what is not, but really much more being really much more transparent to the investors on what are the objectives and how they are being achieved and attained. Although I'm slightly concerned about the very short timing of this piece of regulation, if you think about it, March 21 is really tomorrow, yes, and just 1 year to review all the product ranges and assess the risks and the objective for auto and review the product strategy. That's very, very short.
It is a short period of time, and there are going to be lots of people within investment firms challenged to work really very hard indeed on these topics, and no doubt they will need quite a lot of support and help from service providers across the sector. But I think what is exciting is that we're getting a sense that this is becoming the new normal, and sustainable investing will be a topic that doesn't need its own panel in a few years' time, because it'll just be fully integrated with everything else across the investing universe. So I think we're well on the way to that, which is great.
And going in the right direction.
Indeed.